Hello everybody, this is gonna be, I guess it's an unboxing, even though there's no box, of the knockoff Blitz Gundam that I got from Sir Toys. They put it in the package, so I guess I'll review it. I mean, might as well, right? So, let's look at the plates. We got the A1 plate, which looks about standard. And the A2 plate. And the B plate. Not a whole bunch of flash I see on it. A little bit here. But not too. A little bit on the face mask. Not too bad. Then we have the Polycats, which. Ooh, SD Polycat knockoffs. That's, it's a good thing I have extra Polycats, let's just say that. But it comes with a stand, something the SD didn't come with. It's actually a nice glittery gold. I like it, actually. That's maybe the best thing from the kit. And so let's look at the instructions. It's from the DEYLO company. Never heard of that company ever. It's a sinewy soldier. All right. Is that Violet? That doesn't look like Violet. Not quite. Okay, hold on. Red part, violet part, gray part. Okay. Gunmen. White robot. Gunmen. White robot. And mode. Robot ink pen. I think I get what they're trying to say, but poof. So I got the parts count. I don't think I got the wire. Oh yeah, and also the stickers, which. Oh, they look good. Eh, probably don't stick worth crap. And then we got the instructions, the head, the torso, the arms, the face, the legs. And the weapons. And that's it. Yeah, SD's not that complicated really, and these are more simple ones, but they're actually more articulate than some of the between 00 and age is where we lost the articulation. We got it back now, but these are good for the time, and they're still actually really good for articulation. And I had two others to compare this to. They're actually Bandai, so the weird thing is, you might be saying, "Ew, it's a knockoff," but try and find this guy in a store right now. Go to a store online and try to find the Blitz. Try to find NSD before 00. It can be done. I have seen the Strike Freedom SD on a store in stock, but it's very hard. They don't seem to be restocking SDs that are anything past 00 or before 00, and I don't know why. Because I really like these ones from a seed. I really wish they hadn't screwed it up until below an age, because I would have loved Exia to have this kind of articulation. Anyways, that's another story. So, that's about it. I'm actually gonna build this and then review it in this video, because it's not gonna take long, and it is a knockoff, so I'll see you in a bit. And here is the SD knockoff Blitz all together. Took about as much time as the original. I didn't have to modify anything, didn't have to, forcefully assemble it. It was tighter than the original, but not that bad. Nothing cracked. And, yeah, it was actually a rather decent build. The detail's not as crisp as the original. It never is. But since it's black, it's hard to tell. You'd be hard pressed to notice on the color. Which I think this is actually more of a darker black than the original. Sticker, for what it was, the eye sticker, perfectly fine. I did have to sand off a little bit of flash here on the V-fin and the face mask. That was really it. And it doesn't fall apart. It is a little loose on the legs. And the arms are a little loose at the up here in the arm, but at the elbow joint, but not too bad. So you saw the ball jointed head. You got the swivel arms, which can go out. They bend at two points at the elbow and swivel at the elbow. You got the swivel wrist, kind of tight there. Waist, ball jointed legs, feet, and the hinged toes. And yeah, I realize black model on black background, but I think the light will do the job. So, you can still do some poses with this guy. Because it is an SD, even though the legs are loose, it doesn't really matter. Now, funny thing. I was actually, like, in the unboxing, I said this was cool, they had a stand, but the more I thought about it, where am I going to put it? It is actually having where to put a stand, so I'd have to drill a hole to utilize the stand, which, good idea, guys, but pointless. Now, the actual accessories, you have the claw, I can never remember the names of the weapons the Blitz has, but you have the normal compact mode, and then the open mode, like that, and just pegs into the arm. This one's easy enough to peg into. Now the other one here, which is the shield with the spikes, the spears, and you also have the beam saber, which it can hold. Well, it would hold, but it's very big. I don't actually think the Blitz actually held them. I can't remember. I'll have to compare it with the other one in a minute. But you can connect it like it is in the show, right here. Oh, actually, it's the other way around. There. Like that. Not a super solid connection, but it should stay alright once you put it against the arm. Which, a little harder to do. It's a very... this hole seems to be a little tighter. For this... or the peg's bigger. But it will fit. And there you have it. So, accessories do work. I know there were no stickers on the original either, so... just the eyes. So let's actually get the beams out of there. So let's compare this to the original Blitz. And you can see colors are a little different. The black is definitely more black on the new one, or the new one, wow, the knockoff. And the yellow isn't quite, this is more of an orangey yellow on the original. Purple is about the same. Red is about the same. It just seems to be the black and the yellow that have changed. And because I have it, why the hell not? There is the clear version. The, one of those limited, I think there is a prize one. So yeah, I don't think this will fit in his hand. I think he could hold it. Yes, the original could hold the beam saber, but because you have the connection to the shield, it doesn't really matter, because it was never used like that. It was only on the shield. So that is the knockoff Blitz. It's actually pretty good for a knockoff. If you ever want a knockoff, SD is the way to go, because, like with the legs, even if they're floppy, if this was a high grade or a master grade with floppy legs and feet, he would have a really hard time. But considering it's an SD, it doesn't really matter, because it is already close to the ground. Now, I got this from Sir Toys, but they don't actually have it on their site. But if there's any we've seen, or a third-party kit you've seen somewhere, they have a want list. If you put it in the want list, or like give them the link, hopefully they might be able to pick it up for you. So, but yeah, this is pretty cool. I actually kind of like it. I'm thinking about painting him red, because there's that Nebula Blitz I have in 1/100 scale. That'd be kind of neat. So yeah, all things considered, it's not too bad. And since I can't seem to find, unless you want to go on eBay, I saw an eBay auction where this guy for the original for $30, which I think is kind of outrageous. But yeah, I mean, if you can't find him, this isn't really that bad, surprisingly enough. So that's about it, and I'll see you at the next review.